In mathematics, we often solve for x, but what about y? Today, I want to talk about why taking any number to the power of 0 always equals 1. This is something that I don't think is very intuitive, but a lot of us have just memorized it and have never really been taught why. I want to provide a few different explanations in this video because I know one explanation might not click with everybody. And one of the things I love about math is that there are often multiple explanations or multiple ways to arrive at the same conclusion. So I want to kind of present this in a few different ways. But if you can think of another explanation as to why taking a number to the power of 0 always equals 1, I would love to hear it in the comments. First, I just want to approach this by looking at patterns. Pick your favorite number. For me, I'm going to pick 3. And let's just try out taking 3 to the power of some different numbers. So for example, I might have 3 to the 4th power, which of course is multiplying 3 by itself 4 times. So 3 times 3 times 3 times 3, which gives us 81. Or we could have 3 to the 3rd power. Again, 3 times 3 times 3, or 27. 3 to the 2nd power, or 3 squared, would give us 3 times 3, which is 9. 3 to the 1st power would just be 3. Notice how we can move down this list as we are decreasing the exponent by 1 each time. The result ends up being divided by 3 each time. And this makes sense because if the exponents are telling us how many times to multiply by 3, but our exponents are decreasing by 1 every time, then we're going to be multiplying by 1 less 3 every time. Or in other words, we can get from 1 to the next by dividing by 3. This even works if we use negative exponents. For example, 3 to the negative 1 power would be 1/3. 3 to the negative 2 power would be 1/9. And so going from negative 1 to negative 2, we're subtracting 1. But going from 1/3 to 1/9, we're dividing by 3. So we notice that this pattern is carrying through. So it would only make sense that to go from 3 to the 1st power to 3 to the power of 0, subtracting 1 from our exponent, going from 1 to 0, then we should take our result of 3 to the 1st power, which is 3, and divide it by 3, just like we did in every other step. So 3 divided by 3 gives us 1. So in other words, 3 to the power of 0 equals 1. Now this is just looking at patterns, so I would encourage you to try and formalize that a little bit more to be an actual proof, but I think looking at patterns is a great way to start. Another way we could think of this more conceptually is again thinking about what these exponents mean. So 3 to the 3rd power is saying multiply by 3 3 times. 3 to the 1st power is multiplying by 3 1 time. So 3 to the power of 0 is multiplying by 3 0 times. So intuitively, you might think that would make it equal to 0, but let's think about what it means to not multiply by something. For example, in addition, if we would take 3 plus 0, that would equal 3. Because 0 is the additive identity, and adding 0 to something is basically like not adding at all. But the parallel to that in multiplication would be if we took 3 times 1, that would equal 3, which is almost as if we didn't multiply by anything at all, because 1 is the multiplicative identity. So, if 3 to the power of 0 is telling us that we're multiplying by 3 0 times, or in other words, we're not multiplying by anything at all, then we would be left with 1, the multiplicative identity. You could also think of it as you can always multiply by 1 every time, again, because it's that identity, it's not going to change anything. So if we look back at our list of numbers here, we could just add a times 1 to each one. So we would have 3 times 3 times 3 times 3 times 1, 3 times 3 times 3 times 1, etc. So here we'd have 3 times 1, and notice each time we have 1 less 3, so for 3 to the power of 0, we would just be left with 1, because we're not ever multiplying by 3, because it's telling us to multiply by 3 no times. And finally, I wanted to share with you an explanation that I came across that used properties and rules of exponents. Recall that if we are multiplying two numbers that have the same base, then we can add the exponents together Or in other words, x to the a times x to the b equals x to the a plus b power. But a and b can be any numbers, so let's suppose that b actually equals negative a. So now we have x to the a times x to the negative a equals x to the a plus negative a power, or in other words, x to the zero power. But another property we know is that negative exponents can be rewritten. For example, x to the negative a power can be rewritten as 1 over x to the a. So now we have x to the a times 1 over x to the a, or in other words, x to the a divided by x to the a, and if we are taking something and dividing it by itself, of course we know that's going to equal 1. So we have shown that x to the a times x to the negative a equals 1, but previously we also showed that it equaled x to the 0 power. So that must mean x to the 0 power also equals 1. I hope at least one of these explanations clicked with you and helped shed some light a little bit further onto why taking a number to the power of 0 gives us 1 instead of just memorizing and assuming that to be true. If you've learned other explanations or you can think of your own explanation, I would love to hear it in the comments. But anyways, that's why taking any number to the power of 0 is always going to give us 1.